And in Tallahassee, the Florida Democratic Party hosting an early voting block party at FSU today, encouraging students to vote. Stacey Inez was there. Stacey, you talked with students about their decisions.
Yeah, Julie and Jacob, I did. And some students told me today they really feel more connected to some of the issues that are going on locally and nationally. And they also say now that they're legally able to vote, they're of age to vote, they just feel like now their voices matter. Now, we also did catch up with Leon County Supervisor of Elections, Mark Early. He says they've seen a relatively high turnout among some early voters with young students, particularly college students. Now, some at the block party today say they didn't want to wait until election day to risk not being able to vote at all. I did speak with one Latino student who says he's a first-generation college student and he's able to vote for the first time during this election.
I'm just in that underrepresented population, and when you're a part of that population, it's just really important for you to set some time aside and to go vote, you know, making sure your voice is heard.
I think some people just tend to focus on the national level, but really where you're able to make the most impact should be your local communities.
Now, Mark Early also says some factors that contribute to that high early voting turnout among college students also have to do with their increased partnerships. And he also said their partnerships with university administration to be more visible and present on campuses. He thinks that also has a little bit to do with that early voting turnout increase among college students. For now, live from FSU, Stacey Inez, WCTV Eyewitness News.
And historically, Stacey, younger folks vote at a less often rate than older Americans, so that's good to see. Thank you so much.